Welcome back, everyone. I'm Craven, and this is Trails to Azure. We are deep in the old mine at Mainz, and you know why. There's an exterminated monster down here, and yeah, it was not easy to reach, but we finally got there in the end. So I thought this would be the perfect location to start the episode, and then we can get back out, go to Mainz, and continue our rounds like normal. So there it is, sitting on his butt, waiting for us to come and fight him. So let's do that. And it's a whole bunch as well. Anything we can do? Might just battle scope them. See what we're up against. Megalo Bat. 9,800. Not too bad. Bat that became fat after sucking too much blood. Use its weight to fight. Alright. Let's see if we can balance that out a little bit. Yeah, not too shabby, Aiden. Alright, so what else can we do? We can just do a star blast. I don't think it will be enough to totally wipe them off the map, but if it is, I wouldn't mind. Yeah, I thought it was gonna be like a little bit left. Ooh. I hope I didn't screw myself over by attacking them all at once. Because if they're all doing this, then I am technically screwed. Come on. Alright, we're still here. And we've got the room for one more. That will definitely take care of him. Damn, I almost thought it was gonna be like a worm situation, that they were gonna do all quakes until you just wiped off the map. Was pretty close, but we did it in the end. Exterminated monster in the old mine. Craftbook blast. Look at that, it was hiding a craftbook. I think this one is geared towards Theo and Noel's weapon of choice. Shall we begin testing it, Noel? Oh, I'm game if you are. Let's do this, Theo. Blast Hammer. Yes, by spending 100 CP each, they can unleash a powerful combination attack. Yes, they can. And it was literally at the bottom of the mine, all the way in the back. So you know what that means? That means now I have the pleasure to walk out of this once again. So I will see you when I come up for air, so to speak. So see you then. I did just remember that there was a ladder that helped us get down there a little bit quicker than how I actually got there, because I went the long way around to get down there, but this is no problem. It gave me a bit of extra sepit along the way with all the enemies I picked off one by one. But yeah, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was. Alright, back in Mainz, and let's start our rounds here as well. Oh, the other day, some bracer came by to take out a monster in the northern mountains. They got it just fine, but they also said it was unlike anything they'd ever seen before. I've been hearing about a lot of monsters like that recently. I wonder where they're coming from. Imagine squaring up and fighting mysterious monsters for a living, though. Aren't bracers just the coolest? I have to admit, they can be pretty cool. Some kind of monster appeared in the mountains north of here. They say it looks similar to the one that showed up in the old mine outside of town a while back. I wonder if it really was the same kind. Hey, supposedly the monster they found in the mountain was similar to the one that appeared in the old mine outside of town. Yeah, it really was the same kind, cause we were in the briefing. And we saw it. Oh, lately I've been getting the impression that Marlowe thinks Luca hates him. He hasn't been coming to the bar and I hear he hasn't been able to focus at work either. If Luca doesn't catch on, this could turn into a really sticky situation. On the upside, Gans went to speak with Luca on Marlowe's behalf. I knew the man had some good in him. Unfortunately, Luca can be a tough nut to crack. He's got his work cut out, that's for sure. Anything new? No? Well, we could have a bit of rest here. It's not like... I was gonna say, it's not like we are out of money or anything. We have 700, it costs 6. Now we're broke. That's all you gotta do, Luca. Come on, I'm begging you here. Gans, why do I specifically need to be the one to cheer Marlowe up? Like I said earlier, I'm sure his recent funk has nothing to do with me. I wouldn't be so sure. So be honest, it has everything to do with you. I'm still not following. Marlowe's bound to feel better if Luca can just give him a few words of comfort. I gotta persuade her somehow. I'll tell you what, Gans, pay off your mountain of tap and maybe then I can help out. Wait, how's that got anything to do with this? It has nothing to do with it, but she sees an opportunity if there ever was one. Oh, let's check downstairs. If there's any new guests that popped up? Nope. But it's always good to check. You never know if there's another merchant that comes into town seeking to score a buttload of septiums. Crossbell pays a combined total of 10% of its taxes to the Empire and the Republic. That's a staring amount to ask of a burgeoning economy like ours. The whole arrangement sums up Crossbell's relationship with the two major powers perfectly. It's not a fair situation, but at the moment, it is what it is. To think I'd live to see the day when Crossbell's leadership would propose our independence. Erebonian and Calvard have fought over Crossbell's septian resources for ages. Naturally, this gives us much to consider. Each and every citizen of Mainz is going to have to consider the ramifications of the independence for themselves. That goes for me as well. I'll be mulling Crossbell's future over all the way until the referendum. Yeah, like we said before, it's extremely important for them and they need to get informed. Hey, I heard Loggy stopped skipping out on work. He says he still hates going in, but I don't know. It looks like he's having fun to me. I want to grow up to be a miner who loves his job too someday. Well, if you do grow up and you find a job that you love and you can do it every day without complaining, count yourself as one of the lucky ones. There's not a lot of people that manage to do that. Oh, just imagine, Crossbell an independent state. In all my years, I've never been anything more than a fantasy. Oh, I scarcely remember. Though I can't imagine the Empire or the Republic would ever allow it. Our independence could be the coals that fueled the flames of a new conflict. The Empire and the Republic could never stay their tongues against the prospect of a Crossbellan independence. This proposal could be the cause that fueled the flames of a new conflict. That could very well be, and it probably will be, considering everything we know. Oh, I heard an enormous monster was spotted up north in the mountains. That's not too far from town. What if another one shows up in the mine? Our miners aren't prepared to deal with a beast like that. I worry something like that could appear in the mine too. Our miners aren't prepared to deal with beasts like that. Yes, and that's when you call the SSS or the Brazier Guild. That's what they're there for, and they'll be more than glad to help you guys out. Oh, I don't get what this independence stuff is all about. But Daddy says it's a good thing, and Daddy's always right. Well, if it does happen and it works out, then yes, it can be a good thing, but Crossbell, such a long way of getting there. So Crossbell and independence came up at the trade conference, huh? Now there's an idea. That new mayor of ours has got some real moxie. It's about time we stop rolling over for the Empire and the Republic. Yeah, I can see why he would be up for that. Light punching bag. This one I think we already have. So yeah. So do we sell a few random stuff or do we trade in some? I'm not gonna do that with your material. We're gonna need a lot of it. We do have a lot of these. Cause I don't need them. I don't need much. Just want to make sure that it's not one of those things that we do need, actually. Because I do, for 90%, know for certain that it's one we still need. I mean, one we do not need, that we already gotten before. But I'd rather have a double than miss it at all. Well, Alec wants to become a miner, no doubt, because of his father, the mine chief. Frankly, I'm against it. Still, as a parent, I want my child to be happy. At the very least, I need to keep him safe until he's old enough to make that decision himself. Well, yeah, he does need to get there first. Frankly, I'm against it, but I won't stand in his way. Whatever he decides, I'll be watching over him. Yeah, that's the best thing you can do. Because the more you go against it, the bigger the chance is that he will actually do it. Oh, here I am again in Mainz, the site of my most recent hiking failure. But I've learned my lesson. I'll train my legs and glutes for as many years as it takes to clear these mountains. Maybe I won't be today, but it'll happen, I swear it. Yeah, one day she'll be the strongest person to trek over the mountains. I don't have enough motivation to do anything. Luca probably hates me now. I don't even want to show my face at the bar. Guess I'll wrap up work and head straight home today. It really makes it hard to concentrate on my job. I don't think she hates him, she just doesn't care. Alright, let's see how the rest is doing. I was taking a break outside earlier when Chief Hoffman's son came up and talked to me. Is being a miner fun? He asked. I didn't feel like coming up with an answer, so I just told him to buzz off. This isn't the first time he bugged me about it, actually. That makes twice that I've bummed him out now. I never think before I open my mouth. Maybe I should have said something more positive. It is pretty clear that Chief Hossman's son wants to become a miner someday. Maybe I should have told him something a little bit more optimistic. Marlo hasn't been able to focus on work at all lately. He even turned down an invitation to go drinking. What's getting into him? Ken should be back from his break by now too. For crying out loud, am I the only one who isn't slacking off right now? Yeah, but Gens is trying to look out for his friend, and you can only respect something like that. My wife's been on edge lately because of those large mysterious monsters people keep reporting. I'm used to monsters appearing in the mine, so I doubt we have anything to worry about. That said, I got injured by a warhound a while back, so I guess I shouldn't talk? Just keep my eye open for large mysterious monsters, I guess. Wouldn't want to leave my wife in tears over something happening to me again. Yeah, like I said, at the slightest hint of monsters, just get out, and call the SSS or the Bracer Guild. And everything should be more than fine. Alright, time to head back home. We have another segment, done and dusted. Alright, let's go through the central square and head for the entertainment district through the back alley. Because we wouldn't want to miss anything. Employees only. Is that why I couldn't see a sticker in the back wall? Because they closed the doors to get there? Maybe. This leads to Crimson & Co. The Red Constellation's been laying low since the attack on the conference. I doubt we'd be able to get any info out of them right now. Yeah, we're better off not hanging around here. Ooh, interesting, very interesting. The debate over independence is even less civil on the orbital net. The majority of people seems to be in favor of it at the moment. That is, seems like I have steady stream of entertainment for a while. Let the discourse rage on, I say. The debate over independence is even less civil on the orbital net. Let the discourse rage on, I say. Ooh, a musical box. Again, don't know for sure if you already had it, but this is too expensive just to randomly buy it. So, you know what? We are very close by the SSS building. So, let's go by all the rooms and see if there is a music box. And if there's anything else that we've acquired, we can put it in their rooms at the same time. This is the light punching bag, okay. That one we had. Nothing for him. Nothing for him. Nothing for him as well. Hope that anything we picked up would still be for here. Nope. And I don't necessarily see a music box, so that one might be real. Ah, this spot looks good. A new decoration was added to Noel's room. While at the SSS building, Lloyd and the others decided to take a break from their duties. After a cursory check-in with the CPD headquarters, they each retired to their respective rooms to rest. I think that just about does it. Do you have a minute, Noel? Lloyd, yeah, come on in. Is it time to go? Just about. HQ didn't need anything else in particular from us today. Everyone's still getting ready though, so don't feel like you have to rush. What were you writing over there? Official paperwork? Oh yeah, it's just one of my duties as a temporary transfer. I have to send Commander Bales a report each week. Well, keep up the good work. Wow, seems your room isn't so bare bones anymore, is it? You've got a bike here now. And is that a pair of racing flags on the wall? Oh, you recognize them. Sure, I did live in Calvard for 2 years. Now that I think about it, I saw a lot more bicycles there than I do here. As for the flags, they have orbital cars races over there too, don't they? Yeah, exactly. My late father was especially fond of those actually. Back when I was a kid, he bought us some train tickets and took me on a trip to see a race. He was always busy with the CGF, so we only ever went that one time. I see. So, is the reason why you love cars so much? I'm that obvious, huh? I'd love to watch another race next time I get a vacation of work. No telling when that will be though, if ever. I hear you there. Though, I get the sense you prefer to be behind the wheel instead of in the stands. changing the subject a bit, if there's any basic models you'd recommend, I'd love to hear about it sometime. Oh? Back when I lived in Calvard, I had this friend who was something of a biker. It definitely stoked some interest in me. I was thinking we could go for a ride together on one of the days off. What do you say? Oh, that sounds great! Bikes do a lot more than just get you from point A to B. They're good for a workout, handy in a pinch, and most importantly, fun to ride. I'll bring you a catalog from my house next time. Thanks, I appreciate it. Completed Noel's decoration collection. Okay, so she's done. I'm still thinking that we had like a black bear doll thing in here. For some reason doesn't want to pop up. Oh well. At some point I'm sure it will. I guess it's time for us to head back to the back streets. Alright, having checked that the item that Imelda had is one that we haven't seen. At least I don't think we've seen it in Ellie's room. When we get money, we gotta come back and buy it. So this is parked until we get to the IBC and get a little bit more money into our pockets. Well, hey there, handsome. Wanna have some fun at our club? Okay, I'll level with you. I'm competing with a rival co-worker, and so far we're neck and neck. Whoever wins will this month's top hostess, so can you do me a favor and help a girl out? Oh, you're on the job right now, too. Fine. How about when you clock out? You come to our club and ask for a VIP session with Eris. You can toast to my future victory. Oh, Randy will be there, definitely. All this independence talk is cramping my style. No doubt you feel the same, right? So, what better chance to come in and relax at our club? We'll give you a good time guaranteed. Yes, give you a good damn. Alright, let's check the garante. Latest word on the street is that the Imperial government hired the Red Constellation to intercept those terrorists at the conference. Crimson & Co. has been laying low since then. They've hardly done a thing worth mentioning. Business as usual for them, I suppose. Those Jaegers are about as professional as it gets. Yeah, but considering what they did to the terrorists, I can understand from a business perspective that it's better for them to lay low for a while. Because it wasn't pretty, not even in the slightest. This referendum thing is all anyone's been able to talk about. Eric said I should take part in it too, but that's easier said than done. I mean, the voting hours are right in the middle of my beauty sleep. I'll doubt I'll be doing my civic duty for the referendum unless they decide to give us graveyard shift workers an extension. I mean, the voting hours are right in the middle of my beauty sleep. Yeah, that's mainly the reason if I don't vote too. Because you cannot miss your beauty sleep, because it will just mess you up. Man, Arc and Ciel's got themselves another star in the making. They're priming up that Sully girl to be a new princess in their play. From what I've heard, it hasn't been a year since they found Rixia. Some people have all the luck, huh? That is true. Out of my way, world! I've got my hankering for some gambling today. Only problem is, my wallet's looking pretty dry. Man, my wallet's been taking a real thrashing lately. I can always ask my folks for a little spending money. Do we know what this is for? Oh, well, hello there, Wuzzy. Thank you for showing me such a good time the other day. Our hour together felt like an absolute dream. Same to you, madame. I'm glad I could be of service. Putting aside the moral gray area, how does Wuzzy find time to host in between all of our duties? I'll be seeing you again soon, Wuzzy. Oh, I'm sure he'd be more than willing to help you with that. I may be Crossbellum, but I used to work for a hotel in the Empire. Maybe I shouldn't say this out loud, but the downside for having to cater to Erebonian nobles, it got old fast. My career has been a lot less stressful now that I've moved back home. Working for an Erebonian hotel gave me a much needed experience, but it was also a taxing job to have. My career has been a lot less stressful now that I've moved back home. Then you made a good choice. Unless you love the stress, then it's something different. Oh, the debut of Arc and Ciel's revival show is coming closer by the day. I didn't manage to get a ticket, but I'm still looking forward to hearing how it turns out. Yeah, eventually you might be able to get a ticket. Nobody staying here at all today? This one is sold out. Many of us yearn for independence, but not all. That difference in opinion cannot be ignored. Having lied through the past several decades, I know well that we posed by our neighbors to the east and west. However, perhaps now is the time for Crossbell to make a change, much like the way Hotel Millennium has. Okay. I do wonder who's in that locked room though. Ever so slightly. Oh, should Crossbell become independent? It's a difficult yet crucial question to ask. Only time will tell how the people respond. That is true. But that's probably the reason why the whole referendum is being done. Well, Lady Ilya, Rixia and Sully will be starring alongside each other as the revival three celestial princesses. I even managed to nab me a ticket this time. I've never been more excited. Oh, 3 days. Just 3 more days. And the revival performance debut is so close, you can taste it. I can't wait any longer. Ice cream, get your ice cream. I'm happy to offer a sample if you're having trouble picking between all of my scrumptious flavors. I even have these cutie little spoons you can use to have a taste. Now my grasp in the first place in sales is like an iron vice. Viva la ice cream! Yeah. Ice cream is good, but I don't have the money right now. Opening night is quickly approaching. I can feel the excitement growing among the troop and staff. Myself included, naturally. Where does this time go up first? Ooh. We're even allowed up here. Oh, and they're actually in practice. Ah, that's why. What are you doing up here, Ilya? Oh, if it isn't my favorite little guy and his merry band of friends. I'm guessing you're here to give us some encouraging words before the revival debut. Something like that. Were you looking in how Sully and Rick's rehearsal is going? You know it. I can get a great view from up here without them noticing. It is good to see they don't need me there to give it their all. They both remind me of myself when I first joined the troop. I guess even you were a rookie at some point. Kinda hard to imagine though, huh? Feel free to tell us all about it when you have the time. Oh, it's not that I mind, but I wouldn't want to bore your kids with tears. Oh, we promise you won't. We'd love to hear your story. I remember all the papers mentioning how high expectations were for your first performance. So you had captivated the city even before debuting. If I may ask, what was it that made you pursue a career on the stage in the first place? Oh, that's a good question. I'd say it all started when I watched Arc and Ciel back in my childhood. Ah, I get it. So you want to be just like them, is that it? No, not exactly. It is true their productions were impressive even then, with their talented cast and elaborate sets. But at the end of every show, I would always feel like something was missing, and I just couldn't accept it. What do you mean? Well, everyone and their mother would go on about how amazing Arc and Ciel was. I was afraid there might be something wrong in me to think otherwise. There I was, tiny baby Ilya thinking, come on, I could do better than that. Can you imagine? A total amateur like me thinking she could outshine Arc and Ciel if she was just given a chance. Wow, so you were just as passionate even when you were little. With an attitude like that, I can already see all the friends you've made when you finally landed a spot in the troop. I won't deny it. I was a talentless, inexperienced amateur dancing on the toes of the real pros. But in my heart, I believed I could be one to raise the bar. I told myself that if I let my performance do the talking, then eventually I'd earn their respect and win them over. Which made you who you are today. Maybe. You could know by now that I'm a perfectionist. The catch is, I don't believe Arc and Ciel has ever put on a perfect show. That's why I went out and mint two diamonds in the rough, Rixia and Sully. With the two of them at my side, I believe we're oh so close of putting on the ultimate show I've dreamed of. Wow. You, Ilya, you're the most ambitious person I've ever met. They say hard work beats talent every time. But in your case, Ilya, both of them apply in spades. There really is no one like you. Couldn't have said it better myself. Oh, please, you don't have to flatter me over a boring story like mine. When you guys finally have a night off, you should come and see us put on the revival performance. Rixie and Sully are going to set the stage on fire with yours truly. It's gonna be our greatest production yet. Of course, count us in. We look forward to seeing you put on the show of your dreams, Ilya. Oh, it's been so long since I reminisced about my early days in the troupe. But enough about that. You should come see us put on a revival performance when you guys finally have a night off. Rixie and Sully are going to set the stage on fire with yours truly. It's gonna be our greatest production yet. That part, I can fully believe. Is there anything else up here? Oh, it's been such a long time since we were here. Great view too. Our revival performance debuts in only 3 days. On a related note, we have a dress rehearsal scheduled for all of tomorrow. Please be aware that only the troop members will be allowed in the theater during that time. Okay, we're still gonna try to get in, but now we know the chances are very abysmal. Unless something goes wrong and we have to search for the dresses. Not that I want anything to go wrong, but I wouldn't mind having a preview about how everything looks like. Sully doesn't look so good. I think she got some major jitters over her performance. Well, I wouldn't surprise me. This is her debut. Still, this is a challenge she has to overcome on her own. We ought to just keep quiet and watch over her. Yeah, you're right. Sully is having a difficult time ahead of her debut. But what Theodore said is right. We have to trust her to figure things out on her own. There's nothing you can do to help someone who hasn't noticed their own problems. Ilya probably understands that the most, as much as she wants to jump in. That's probably why she's watching from so far up in the banners, just to make sure that she can fully experience her on stage without giving her hints where something goes wrong, because in the end, Sully needs to do it on her own. Yes, she got all the lessons, all the directions, but in the end, she needs to be on stage on her own and do the thing she needs to do. Personally, I think she can do it. Does that first performance need to get out? Because when she does that, the rest should be a lot easier. Nikolai scored such a big important role. Well, I'm here lagging behind. Oh, what are you complaining about, Celine? You'll have plenty more appearances this time than before, won't you? Maybe. But compared to the others? Oh, no one's comparing you to anybody. Don't you realize that? This troop only has one Celine, and that's you, sweetie. Now, come on, put a smile on for me, will you? All that scowling is going to ruin your makeup. Celine has always been a warrior. I understand how she feels, but I hope she can learn to move past it. Oh, of course I'm the only Celine here, but is that enough? Probably. Oh, where's Karelia? Karelia, when you need her? Oh, beggars can be choosers, I guess. Hey, Eugene, can I ask you a favor? What is it, Lee? My sash has loosened up a tiny bit. Okay, I can't tie by myself, so would you be a doll and help me out, will you? You can't be serious. Don't plea. Why am I so nervous? Though I fear one mistake will send me off to the gallows. That's almost a guarantee. Eugene's a little more innocent than I gave him credit for. Seeing I'm flustered about is making even me feeling a little embarrassed. Yeah. Well, it could be very, very intimidating to do something like that on an actress. The set that had the studio built for our revival production will finally be ready tomorrow. We threw in some pretty insane design specifications this time around. But no matter how impossible it seems on paper, Meister Jörg always pulls through for us in the end. I'm excited to pick it up. Look, Rixia and Sully are on stage. Is that Sully's Star Princess costume? Oh, it's gorgeous. Yeah, but take a close look at Soldier. Seems a little uncomfortable up there. Oh, how is that, Avan? Perfect, right? He's gonna be blown away by my skills. Well, I would give it passing marks, yes. Huh, is that all? What about you, Rixia? Tell me what you think. I didn't mess up a single step, right? If I had to offer a word of advice, Sully, it would be to put a little more emotion into your movements. It is difficult to explain, but it may help to picture yourself the way you want the audience to see you. How I want to see me? Can you be more specific? Renny's right. She's struggling. We would probably leave them be. I agree. This can be a bad time to interrupt. Rixia and Sully are focused on rehearsing right now. We shouldn't interrupt them. Yeah, I just hope Sully can find her light and perform to her best capabilities. Cause it's important to her. She wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't. Oh, hey there. Wanna play? You know, I'm not always rocking this cute bunny look, in case you're wondering. But if my boyfriend asks nicely enough, I'd definitely break it out just for him. Yeah, I can imagine that. Alright, also, we definitely need to get all the goods here before it changes up. Oh, I have no interest in overgrown children still nursing off their parents' mirrors and status. Suave, refined men like Mr. Drake are much more on my alley. It doesn't matter how much mirror you have, you couldn't pay me to humor some pretentious layabout. Suave, refined men like Mr. Drake are much more on my alley. The three gentlemen to my right have been rude and obnoxious to our other guests since the moment they arrived. Don't they have any common decency? This continues, I have to straighten them out with a stern warning myself. Ah, damn, that's one classy mama sitting over there. Sucks that she's turned us down, but I guess we can't all have good taste. Hey, don't push your luck, Yuri. We might get thrown out if you win too much. Oh, I was making a huge fuss of this independence garbage. What a bunch of morons. You Crossbellans should keep your mouth shut and obey your republic like the dogs that you are. If you value peaceful life to this. Hearing that, does give me more reason to go against that, the Republic. Yes, I'm all for the independence. I was doubting myself, but hearing him, I'm all for it. Independence, to be or not to be? It's no easy question to answer. Major Qua has raised the stakes on us considerably. He definitely did. I, for one, am 100% behind Crossbell's bid for independence. It's downright unbelievable that we have to give Erebonia and Calvard a portion of our revenue tax. Our independence is an undeniable right, and don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Several of our guests appear to be causing quite the commotion downstairs. I may have to ask them to leave if they refuse to settle down. Yeah, I think you might need to do that, because they are very pretentious. Alright, that should be the entertainment district. Still have a little bit left. So let's get over to the next area. Oh, that terrorist attack on the conference was a heavy blow to the CBD's reputation. We'd only just been getting people's trust back after the cult incident, but now we're back at rock bottom. It feels like the entire city is giving the department flak over it. I would know, after standing around here. Though, of course, I doubt they feel that way at all about the SSS. Really? I haven't even considered it. Have things really become that hostile, friends? How can you tell? Well, for starters, it's hard to ignore the snark people give us when we're on patrol lately. They'll ask why we even bother showing up to work and thank us for our service sarcastically. You know, like, now Calvard and Erebonian can keep taking advantage of us. Great job. That kind of thing. The worst part is, I can't even say they were wrong. It's pouring salt into the wound. And that sounds harsh. Well, no matter how salty they are, all we can do is keep chugging along. Oh, there's no use in worrying about what you can't control. It's better to focus on things you can do instead. Just do what we do and block out the haters. Talk is cheap after all. Well, those are some good points. Thanks, guys. I needed that. Anytime. Arc and Ciel's revival performance debuts 3 days from now. Not only that, I managed to get tickets for opening night. I've never been so excited in my life. Right, let's do a round first before we head into any of the buildings. Oh, people say there's a lot of good and bad things about Crossbell going independent. I don't really get what any of it means, though. No matter how hard I think about it, I can't decide whether Crossbell should be independent or not. Like I said, it's a hard choice, no matter what you pick. Oh, hey there, can I interest you guys in my newest limited time free drink? In line with Crossbell's trending theme of independence, it's made exclusively with local ingredients. It's packed to the brim with delicious flavors brought to you by our state. Come on, you gotta try it at least once. Azureberg tomato soda? Ew, and this does give us 20 CP, so it's not all bad. Shall we do the police station as a last thing? Oh, hey guys! Looked like you were settled with handling those cryptic things, huh? The report said that they're like the monster you encountered back in the old mine outside of Mainz. Yeah, it's hard to say that what they are beyond that. Exactly, but we're going to keep investigating until we find out. Fran, is something bothering you? It's just, well, I don't want anything to happen to you guys. The sacred cryptids are supposed to be crazy strong. Well, that much is certainly true. But I promise we won't bite off more than we can chew. You don't have to worry so much, friend. Yeah, I know. The SSS has already made it through way tougher things than this. But I'll keep cheering you on all the same. And once you come home, you'll have a patented friend seeker smile on your terminal waiting to hear from you. Aw, oh, hell yeah. I'll call dibs on making the next report to Fran. Be careful on those cryptids, okay guys? You've got better than Fran's seeker smell waiting to take your reports when you get back. Oh, here, your current mission has you working with our local bracers. Who'd have thought at the start of the year that you'd reach this point, where you could stand shoulder to shoulder with the guild? The SSS never ceases to amaze me. Oh, it looks to me like you've been hard at work filling out your comeback notebook. I'd like to record your information into our database. Mind if I see it for a minute? Oh, with pleasure. Oh, thank you very much. Here's your notebook back. And please accept this as compensation for your hard work. Oh, don't forget to stop by once you collect more monster data, okay? Thanks, we will. Of course, we'll keep you updated. Perfect. Margaret, how could you do this to me? You never had eyes for other men before. What changed? I have to do something before I lose her for good. I must.
It's Vice Commissioner Pierre. Not often you see him on the first floor. Oh, it looked like something is troubling him.
The SSS? How long have you all been standing here? Don't tell me you heard what I was just saying just now.
Well, we didn't catch anything specific, if that's what you're... that makes you feel better.
No, you did mention something about a Margaret having eyes for other men.
Could that be the name of your favorite hostess, Vice Commissioner? How dare you! You watch your slanderous mouth. Margaret is the name of my missus.
Missus?
You mean your wife. Yes, you fool. Between losing my wedding ring and being passed over of the role of commissioner, she's been nagging me like never before. Wait, what am I doing telling you all of this?
That's right. The first commissioner came off as pretty whipped when he lost his ring. That was months ago, but from the sounds of things, it's still giving him grief.
So be it. I have no other choice. Beggars can't be choosers at a time like this. Look alive, SS. I'm giving you a top secret mission straight from your vice commissioner.
Top secret? What are you talking about?
I'll be frank. I would like for you to investigate my wife.
You want us to look into your old lady?
Utilizing your position for private matters not violate department policy?
You let me worry about department policy. Time is of the essence here. Considering the formal support request or any whatever they're called, if it makes you feel better, what do you say?
Well, I guess that we could. Yes, we aren't merit counselors, but let's help the poor guy out. Okay. You clearly need a hand, so can you start over from the beginning?
You really help me then? Good, I'll tell you everything you need to know, but not out in the open. Follow me to my office. We can discuss the details there.
Your wife has been seeing a host?
That's right. As I understand, she's been going to several such clubs lately. However, there's one host in particular who she's been meeting with in secret.
And you're positive this man is a host? I was about to ask the same thing. Don't you think you should have a little more faith in your wife?
I do, but I decided to risk it all to find out for sure. That's how I came across the evidence in her purse. Margaret is meeting with a mysterious man named Clyde. It was right there, in her daily planner. What kind of a man is a name like that? It's a stage name, it has to be a host.
I wouldn't call that irrefutable, but I won't say he's categorically wrong either.
Dude's grasping for every story he can find.
So you think she's seeing a host, do you?
Sorry to tell you, but I've never heard of anyone who goes back Clyde. And believe me, I would have.
What?
Seriously, was he? Hey, it's a social business. Speaking generally, I know the names of all the hosts working the clubs in the entertainment district. I can't rule out the chance that he's some rookie who slipped my notice, though.
Wait a minute. You seem awfully knowledgeable about all of this. Don't tell me you're that new addition to the SSS. The one who is, in fact,
a host? Yes.
You scoundrel! You're a member of the police force. What would people say if they found out what you did off-duty?
Please try to calm down, Vice Commissioner. What matters right now is figuring out what exactly your wife has been up to. That's right. And trust us, we've already tried to lecture him on the particular issue. There's no getting through to him.
Their words, not mine.
Back on topic. You mentioned searching through your wife's purse, correct? Not that I condone the act, but did you find anything else that might benefit our investigation?
Well, let me think. Now I remember. Her appointment reminders also had a local pencil in alongside them. Apparently, she's been visiting the restaurant in Central Square almost every afternoon.
The restaurant in Central Square? You mean Things Apt? If this guy truly is a host, why would he meet your wife in broad daylight?
It's not uncommon.
a little secret tryst while the husband's at work. It happens more often than you think. Plenty of hosts have regulars that they only meet with during the day. Then I'm right, aren't I? Again, Vice Commissioner, settle down. And could you stop riding him up on purpose, Buzzy? Who, me? Why, I never. At any rate, I think we have a good grasp of the situation now. Would you mind stepping back and leaving the investigation to us? Fine. Whatever you think is best. Just make sure you get to the bottom of this. But do so with the utmost discretion, am I clear? Understood. We'll get right on it. Man, I can't believe we agreed to this. To be fair, the Vice Commissioner did seem genuinely concerned about his wife. I think it's worth investigation until we see the truth of the matters for ourselves. Eh, if you must. So, where should we begin? Well, let's try the restaurant in Central Square first. If his wife has been there with the alleged host often, we might be able to get some information from him too directly. That sounds like a good place to start as any. Shall we all? Why is he so into this? Quest Pierre's marital peril started. Yeah, we'll have to get back to Central Square to check that out, but not today. No, I'm gonna leave those two till next time, cause they look to be in a very serious discussion, so we'll drop in on the next one. For now, I think we're gonna leave it here. On the next one, of course, we're gonna try to complete the marital problems of Pierre as well, to start off with, and then of course continue with our rounds, like finishing off this location, going to the new Orcus Tower, IBC Harbor, that kind of stuff. So still plenty of people for us to talk to, and of course potential quests to find. So until then, I wish you all a great night, morning, day, wherever you are, and if you're still here, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, and be back next time. See you then. Bye bye.